Haley, since being concise with words isn't necessarily a strength of mine, I don't ever find the exact right words to explain how much you mean to me. But that's also why I'm so blessed to be able to spend the rest of my life with you. Someone who brings strength to our relationship where I may fall short. I'm so blessed to spend the rest of my life becoming a better person because of you. Haley, I vow to never give up, to grow with you, never away from you, to prioritize our needs over either of our wants. I vow to appreciate and be faithful to you, to love you in sickness and health, for better or worse. I vow to love you for the rest of our lives.
I know. Stop crying.
I'm not.
Okay, good. I guess you're making me cry.
It's a you thing.
Dane, I knew that I was going to marry you from the moment we started dating. I knew that this awkward, high-pitched voice, leg-shaking, talking in circles man was for me. Not a day goes by that I don't love you more than I did the day before. You are silly, goofy, and always down for a good time. You are my match, my soulmate, my person. Nothing about us is forced. Everything fell into place and always feels natural. Thank you for putting up with my plans, my ideas, my visions, and my picky nature. I vow to continue to give you the space to be as creative as you can be. I believe that we have established a foundation that is truly solid at its core. I vow that as we build a life, brick by brick, I will work through obstacles with you and trust that regardless of the design plan, we will build something truly magnificent. I vow to dedicate our lives to the collection of wonderful smush-faced puppies that run around our lake house while we sit on the dock, toes in the water, drinking old fashions. I vow to love you always and forever through the difficult days, nights, and mornings. Dane, I love you.
With the joining of hands and the giving and the receiving of rings, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the state of California, I hereby pronounce that they are husband and wife. Family and friends, joining the two houses together, it is my pleasure to introduce to you for the first time, Dane and Haley Becker.
You know, everyone always talks or tells stories about when they see a loved one meet their partner, and they're like, oh, there's just like that look, or like they just talk differently. I remember Dane coming back to town. I don't remember the event, but he was talking about Haley, and just, you could see the glow when he was talking, and you could just hear the love, even though those weren't the words he would use to describe it in the moment, you could just tell. So that was definitely something where it was like, all right, well, we don't need to worry about remembering any other names in the future.
When Haley first brought up Dane, there was something completely different in her eyes. It was different from the very, very beginning. Haley decided that taking Dane to meet 30 of her closest friends as a second date was a wonderful idea. So we went to Big Hat Days, and Dane, by the end of the night, knew almost everybody's name, had had an intimate conversation with 99% of the people there. And if he didn't know them, he was like, okay, who is that person? I need to go talk to them. He was in. We all knew it, and he was in, and from that moment on, he was the one. As we all know, Haley has the purest heart. We could not have asked for a kinder friend, sister. Haley is selfless, she is caring, she is loving, and she is the most hardworking person I have ever met. it's been such a blessing to watch them fall in love and become a unit, and not just two people who are amazing as individuals, but become amazing as a couple.
So, is it going to this button?
Yes.
So, yeah.
So the sides go first.
Yep. So, but we
got to
twist it.
Oh, speaking as a single man, my best marriage advice is that it's a partnership. There's going to be stuff you disagree on. There's obviously going to be times where you're going to be fighting, but as long as you can come together, communicate, and kind of work through it as a unit, and as a pair, as a team, you're going to be fine. And make Dane sleep on the couch.
Keep a sense of humor. You always have to have a sense of humor, because hopefully it's going to be many, many years, and that's what's going to make it most enjoyable. Right, honey?
She did the same thing you would.
Dane, he compliments the family just so perfectly. He's just like one of the kids. I have two wonderful son-in-laws now. And let me tell you how wonderful he is. He took me to Toby Keith. They drove me all the way down to Toby Keith, and we had so much fun. And I think what is special to me is he makes her happy. She is happy with him. They love each other. They both compliment each other. They have the same goals in life. They agree with so many things in their path. It's just going to be great. And I just want to thank you both, and congratulations to both of you. And I'm happy to claim you as my son-in-law forever and ever and ever. You're not going anywhere, okay? Because, you know, Toby will retire one day, so we have to see him again.
I'm not going sentimental because I'll start crying. I know you two love each other very much. Very happy to have Haley in the family. Dane, we all love you. We're all here to support you as well. And we always wish the best for you and are excited to be part of your future as well.
Dane and Haley, I wish you nothing but happiness moving forward. I know you both mean pretty much the world to each other, so I see nothing but happy days and bright sunny days in your future. Much love.
Hey guys, good day. Have fun.
Dane and Haley, we love you so much. We are so happy for you and are grateful that you are in our family. Love you both.
One, no tears are running, and two, it's not fair because you went first. Yeah. If dad doesn't hold up, then you still win the bet.
I wonder if it's you.